We resist the devil when we use the word against him.
That's right.
The most effective you will ever be when you resist the enemy is when you use the word of God against him.
That's right.
Amen. Jesus is known as the living word. Am I right? Yet he, Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, he himself said, I am going to use the written word against the enemy. Over in Luke chapter 4, we have the account of when Jesus went up into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil. He had been fasting and praying for 40 long days, and the enemy came as he was walking through the desert, and there must have been a rock that was shaped like a loaf of bread. And the enemy says, look, if you are the Son of God, well, you know, just listen to what he says. If you're the Son of God, why don't you go ahead and take that rock and make it into bread so you can get something to eat. And I want you to notice what Jesus did. It's one of the most powerful things that he uses. It's a little phrase that needs to be in the vocabulary of every single believer. Amen. A phrase you need to know, and you need to know how to use it. He said to the enemy, he said, it is written. He said, it is written, man does not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. In other words, Jesus himself used the written word to resist the enemy and cause him to flee. Well, let me tell you what happened. The same thing happened. The enemy took him up on top of a high mountain, and all at once he showed him all the kingdoms of the world. And how many of you know that those kingdoms right now are underneath the sway and the authority of the enemy? He could give them to Jesus. And he said, Jesus, he said, let me tell you what, I'll give you all of these kingdoms if you'll just bow down and worship me. But Jesus, once again, he resisted the enemy. He said, get behind me, Satan, for it is written, you shall worship the Lord your God, and him only shall you serve. And then a third time, see, Satan took Jesus up to the pinnacle of the temple, and he tried to twist the word. He tried to make it say something that it shouldn't have said. And so now it's the enemy saying, it is written.
That's right.
And he said, look, he said, listen, the scripture says that he will command his angels and give them charge over you, so you won't even stub your toe against a rock. You won't even dash your foot against a stone. Why don't you just go ahead and prove to everybody that you are indeed the Son of God and jump off of the pinnacle of this temple? And Jesus, although he did not use the word, it is written, he did quote Deuteronomy chapter 6 and verse number 16. He said, it has been said, you shall not tempt the Lord your God. So what do we learn from Jesus in this account? We learn that the word of God is absolutely a weapon.
That's right.
Now I pray that you never ever get robbed. I pray that a thief will never come to you and rob you. But I can tell you that if you were holding some type of a weapon, how many of you know that the thief would probably think a time or two before he tried to rob you? Am I right on that? And that's why the scripture calls Satan a thief. He is trying to rob you of your blessings. He's trying to steal your joy, steal your victory. He comes to kill and to steal and to destroy. But let me tell you something. Not only do you carry a badge, amen, that says with the authority of the name of Jesus, but you also carry a weapon, which is the word of God. That's why Paul said, taking the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. And let me tell you something, when you pull out that sword and when you start saying it is written, I'm telling you that the enemy says, uh-oh, this is one of those kind. I better back up. I better get out of here. I better run. Come on, is there anybody everybody that in your mind you can see those spiritual forces fleeing from you. I'm just here today to tell you that you have everything that you need to be able to resist the enemy. We start teaching our Ranger kids the Pledge of Allegiance to the Bible.
Amen.
Put your right hand out like you're holding a Bible. We say, I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word. I will make it a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I will hide its word in my heart that I might not sin against God. I'm just here today to tell you that when you memorize the word, when you put it down on the inside, when you study it, when you know it, let me tell you something, the authority level, the weaponry level that you're going to have, it begins to augment itself. I can just tell you this, the good news is that he will flee. It doesn't say that the enemy will kind of slink off. It doesn't say, no, the battle's going to last forever and forever. No, sir, the scripture says, resist the devil and he will flee. Amen? Amen. Come on, can somebody give your king a hand of praise today? You are not weaponless. You have authority. You have the name of Jesus. You submitted yourself to God. You washed your mind with the word so much that it's penetrated down into your soul. So all you got to do is take the sword of the Spirit and you are ready to stand. Amen.